We are reacting to Edmund Breach again. A woman rejects everyone on the button and then gets told the truth. Oh yes, we gotta hear this, cause that bitch right there got a strong face. Got a chin that look like Arnold Schwarzenegger. However you say that nigga last name.
I don't know that we have...
Look at her teeth.
Someone for you.
I find that controversial.
If you don't get take your beautiful titties up out of here, bro. Yo, take them gorgeous.
Oh, hold on. Now I gotta see.
I don't know that we have someone for you.
I find that controversial.
If gorgeous ass knockers, then milkers from the heavens and get the fuck up out of here.
What's your name?
Wait, why are you bleeping out yourself, Abba? You probably got a limited on it.
Alex.
Limited on one of your videos.
Yes.
Elgin, nice to meet you.
Why are you wearing sunglasses inside?
Honestly, I really don't like people in my eyes, but I'll take them off though. I got you.
Thanks.
Take them off.
Got nice eyes.
It's like going on a date and you got a hoodie on the whole time. Like, can you shirt? You don't think that's just fucking weird?
Of course it is. Yeah, so I was thinking about... Yeah, so yo, so what you like to do for like for fun?
What kind of date is that?
Fun fact about Alex, she ripped her butthole freshman year of college and...
Damn!
She ripped her butthole.
Hey, yo.
She waited 3 painful months before seeing 2 doctors to repair it.
I fully regret putting that in my application. Yeah, I mean, just freshman year, eating dining hall food, afraid to like use public bathrooms, just like didn't go well. And something bad happened one day and...
What?
How you do that?
She was eating dorm food or something.
What?
And she was afraid of public bathrooms.
She held
3-4 weeks.
Wow, that's crazy.
And someone came up to her, he's like, "You like California?" She went,
"Yeah!"
And that was September, and I had to wait until I went to my doctor at home, so.
Oh my God.
Damn.
There's a lot of pain for a long time. Yeah. So. Nothing embarrassing ever happens to you.
Not like that.
A pretty smooth individual, if I'm not lying to you.
Why did you reject Elgin?
I feel like you have to have something more embarrassing.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm Haley.
Ooh.
Goddamn titties.
They were there.
Yep.
Titties. Present.
Let me roll that shit back just so.
Hello.
How are they poking?
I'm Haley. I'm Jamil.
Jamil.
Nice to meet
you. Her face ain't
went,
there,
hello,
though.
Hello, and the titties went, oh. Maybe that's just me making up physics in my head.
Yeah, it's freak.
Hello, anyway.
No, it's yeah, zombie.
I don't know. I felt like if I saw titties doing this, I'd just be like,
yeah, zombies. Hey, girl.
Hello, titties.
Y'all be too
not
stupid.
Not even, hey, girl, the titties. He's not even talking to the girl. He's talking to the titties.
If your titties are out there, that's, I might so just say hello.
Offensive.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Hold on, bro. Let me turn my camera on.
Hey.
I'm Jamil.
Jamil.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
The face ain't there, though.
She did she go went, like this.
Nice to meet you, too.
She went like
this. Oh, yeah, she did.
I'm lying.
No shag of the cat.
No.
I like the tattoos.
He's gay. Jesus.
Thank you so much. I just got them.
Do yours mean something to you?
The sun and moon that I have. Mm-hmm. My mom has a sun and moon tattoo.
Okay.
I love astronomy.
Well, what sign are you?
We're gonna go straight to it.
I'm like,
yep.
Sorry.
Yeah, can you guys?
Bam! I said astronomy, not astrology.
Why? And you can be honest, I can handle it.
I would say I'm not sexually attracted to you.
Mm-hmm.
Done.
Good, how are you?
Good, Renard.
Bernard, I'm Haley.
Haley? It's also Renard.
Renard, I'm so sorry.
It's like the French word for fox.
Bro.
Renard, listen.
Button.
Pranjit, okay? You coming out here saying Renard, nobody believes you.
Retard.
No matter how many Hawaiian shirts you wear, that shit not gonna change.
Renard just sounds...
Was that you or me?
Definitely.
Yes, you.
That's okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bernard. Yeah. Have a great day. Renard, sorry.
Why did you reject Renard?
Not my type.
What is your type?
Ooh, I really like a tall person. Hi.
That's it?
What's your name?
Mo.
They took the tallest nigga out there.
They did.
They went in the middle Africa, fetched them a Maasai warrior.
He didn't even fit in the camera, dog. Look at this dude. He didn't even fit in the whole camera.
Mo.
They took the tallest nigga out and be like, put them jeans on. No, we going fishing.
I think I know who this guy is. This is Muhammad. Okay. Yeah, this is Muhammad Ahmed.
Are you Muslim?
Yeah, that guy. I think it's him. I think he's like Sudanese or something.
Wait, what's your name?
I already said it. You forgot?
I forgot.
It's Mo.
Is it short for something?
Yeah, Muhammad. Muhammad Osama Muhammad Ibrahim Ahmed Al-Jazuli. That's my full name.
You're Muslim?
he went Muhammad Ahmed Allahu Akbar Mashallah.
You're Muslim?
Muhammad three times. And Muhammad is in the mirror. You understand what I'm saying? And she asked, are you Muslim?
What's her name? Muhammad Ahmed. Are you Muslim?
No, my last name is James III. I'm Christian.
Fun fact about Haley. They're poly.
Oh. Yeah.
I'm definitely a monogamous type of person.
Yeah.
It felt bad. Yeah.
This breaks
like
my heart.
Idea. I know. I feel like we were vibing.
No, we were super vibing. But it was going to come out anyway.
Come on.
Hello. I'm Haley.
Mark. Hello. I've heard you've been.
All right. So maybe she ain't in the black guy. So he's tall and white.
Buzzing a few people.
He looks all right.
You have some things to say about it?
No.
No.
I understand it. I like Picky, so.
How old are you?
23. How old are you?
I'm 30.
Ooh. Damn, bitch. And you on the button? Wait, I didn't pause the video, did I? I did.
That was a diss. That was a low-key diss. He said 23, and she went, what can you talk about? That was a diss. That was low-key.
I think they forgot to edit that part out. I think that's what it was.
People didn't catch it. That was a diss. What? Like, you're 23. You can't talk about much. So, what do you like? Pokemon? Digimon? What's your thing? Yeah, that was a diss. Yeah. That was a diss.
Every time I pause, I just start going back to looking at her.
Of course you.
But
you
I was going to say.
Are there any type of philosophers that you would say you find yourself really akin to, or that like really have influenced you?
Hmm?
Kanye West, Steve Jobs, and my father.
Kanye West, Steve Jobs, and my father. That's not the most fucking
23-year-old shit to say.
Yeah, that's the most Gen Z loserish shit. Steve Jobs? You're 23. How long has Steve Jobs been dead for?
2011, so he'd be about 11. Right. Yeah. Well, that's actually good. Now, Kanye West, I can understand because he's alive and he's doing. You can see his progress throughout the years. You can see what he's doing. His father, yes, of course, because his father's probably in his life. But Steve Jobs, I mean, he could if you know, watched a few movies and did your research on him, or I don't know. Two people are still alive. One is dead. 11 years old. When he was alive,
long enough for him to remember.
Yeah.
I mean, like, this guy must have been in his mid-teens talking about Steve Jobs. Yeah. What, this nigga look at an iPhone every day and be like,
wow,
I love those blue boxes.
I don't even know.
Inspirational.
I don't even know.
If message.
Did you just say Kanye West?
He creates culture. He creates conversation.
He does.
People's minds.
He does.
But he's anti-Semitic, like. And he's against
He is not anti-Semitic, you idiot. He just don't know how to talk. That's the problem with his ass. He'll say something smart in one sentence and then dumb the very next sentence, which is why he didn't get that job at Louis Vuitton and his friend did. R.I.P. Virgil. Kanye is too much of a wild card.
But the thing that yeah, I know, but as far as
Kanye West really shook me, y'all. That was really hard. Oh my god.
No,
we're gonna
won't.
Take a break from the myth.
Hello.
Oh, this is funny.
Ooh, what the fuck? Why hit that button fast.
We were just playing Truth or Drink in the dressing room, and Chris just had a question of who would you be most sexually compatible with out of this group.
That a dude?
And lo and behold, it was me.
Yeah, so I didn't. You're training to
become a certified sex coach.
What?
Yeah. That's so cool.
They think there's a lot of healing with sex. Mm-hmm. And there's so much.
So that means you're good at it.
Shame behind all of it.
Jesus Christ. That bitch is hitting that button hard. That ugly ass bitch is hitting that button.
There's so much shame.
Yo.
Shame. I love you forever. Good in your honor. Shame.
I wanna be. Wanna be.
Aw. Ooh, she look hurt.
Okay.
No, 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 no. Oh, still looking at titties.
Sorry. I will say. She stood up. I went,
Jesus Christ, my dude, you got issues with titties.
I don't have issues. I appreciate some natty. I appreciate some good natties. I'll say this. There's something funny about like the people who are always like empathy and kindness and this and that. And like the moment you force them to make a choice, they go as cutthroat as anybody else being like, get the fuck up out of here.
Or they don't.
What you mean?
It's either this or like they can't choose, but it's really the fact
this
that
this is a safe space. Yeah, you can say.
Who said that?
previous video. Said that? No, previous video. Different.
You pressed the button.
We're going to talk about a different girl, different video, and now.
No, but the people who always do this, oh, this is a safe space, you can do that, they often are the ones who are the most ruthless.
I know we're an amazing person.
You don't even know her.
Right.
Yeah. You're such an amazing person. Blah, blah, blah. You shut up. Her.
Oh, hello.
Hey.
Ugh, hit the button.
So, what are you into?
I'm into people.
What?
I'm into their energy.
Never mind what the fuck I said. You just said, hold on. You just, like, you made me lie. You just made me fucking lie. Because we were rooting for you. Because you just said you were not particularly into women. And now you're going to say that you're into people. You're not into people. You got a type. The number of time that you buzz, you have a type.
What about for you?
Yeah, for me, I don't know. I've mostly dated men, but I find women immensely attractive. I'm actually more attracted to.
You know what? Her face actually looks good. If she lost all that weight.
Women than I am men.
You're making me lie. You're making me lie, my girl. Cause you're saying it. Oh my God.
I'm into people.
You're saying.
I'm into people, but they have to be tall. They can't be too young. They can't be too old. They gotta be hot enough.
That's
they
not
can't
people.
Look too trans. They can't look too this. They can't look too brown. They can't look too confused. They can't be too Renard. They can't be too Bernard. They can't be too. Monogamous, they can't be too. I was like, oh, bitch, you're not into people, bro.
Honestly, listen, here's the solution, because I don't think people are ready for the solution. The solution is that it's going to take about 2 generations for people to get it. I know we making YouTube videos now, and really, this is all entertainment right now. You know, we getting paid and stuff and making some money and stuff. This is all entertainment at this point. I think everybody knows the information. These bitches just gonna have to die alone, in the words of Kevin Samuels, in order for them to get it. It's gonna take about this generation and the next one for them to get it. And it's gonna heavily depend on you men for this to come to pass. Because if you simps actually do not follow through with the red pill rhetoric, and I don't mean not getting married, I mean letting these feminist bitches die alone. Like, I believe that women should be equal too. I don't believe that, oh, a woman don't need a man. Well, listen, we all need each other. So those type of bitches have to die alone, and it has to be in masses. For about 2 generations, it's gonna take you men not marrying these women. I don't understand why you dudes marry in this country anymore, suck ass niggas. It's gonna take y'all to not marry these women for these bitches to understand that if you act like this ugly ass bitch, she got big titties though. If you act like this ugly ass bitch, you will die looking like this ugly ass bitch by yourself. It's going to take 2 generations of men to be ruthless and say, nah, I ain't fucking with you. But do y'all got the balls to do that? I don't think so.
No, confused. They can't, lie, they can't be too Bernard. They can't be too Bernard. They can't be too monogamous. They can't be too. I was like, oh, bitch, you're not into people.
Bro, never mind.
You like into said, one like percenters.
Like I said.
And I don't mean bunny wise. I mean like really different.
Your choice doesn't reflect what you actually. You masqueraded into something that is very general. I'm into people, but then your choices doesn't show that, my girl.
I think that, ironically enough, her blessing is her curse.
What do you mean?
Blessing.
Titties.
Oh.
Yes. Being born with those titties has fucked her up. Has really fucked her up.
She got an issue.
You really do, though. Of arrogance, what is up with like, you and these titties?
You think it's
this
arrogance?
Bitch is ugly.
It is compounded by the existence of her titties.
You think it's arrogant?
Like, I would say it's a. With those.
Preach. She has chompers for teeth. That bitch can probably. This bitch could probably eat a tree the way them teeth look on her face. And she has a chin like the crimson chin off the Fairly Odd Parents. What do you mean these titties? Well, I mean.
Oh.
The titties,
the titties are the reason why she gets the attention she gets. And because she gets the attention she gets, it reinforces whatever.
She must be real good at sex, too.
I don't think an ugly woman can have nearly as much weirdness like this as her.
If she's entitled,
she gotta have something. You can't be that ugly if she gets hers. I know this girl gets whatever she wants when she wants it. You wanna know why?
Yeah.
Cuz?
Titty.
Yes. With those, she goes on a dating app, she's getting thousands of swipes. But you take those teeth without those titties, you subtract.
You subtract.
Yeah, cause she can take a good selfie with them titties. And I'm gonna be honest with you.
To the roof.
Oh yeah. Hey. Who doesn't wanna suckle on those? But if she didn't have those, I think life would have humbled her. I'm going to be honest with you.
How many sexual experiences have you had with women?
Probably, I wouldn't say like six.
Love.
Do you two find each other attractive?
She does not find her attractive.
But she's going to lie about it because it's a girl.
And you want to know how I know? Because I saw what she looked like when she found somebody attractive, aka the big tall black dude. Girl was smiling, she was yes queening everything. Now she's more monotone.
Swinging that, dig him
out. And she's going to shake her
head. You're stunning. I think you're absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Woo!
You both said you found each other attractive, but you were both ready to hit the button.
Right.
You see this?
They both lying.
She did not answer the question.
Yeah. She didn't say, see, the button says you both said you found each other attractive, but you were very ready to hit the button. Okay. She didn't say she found her attractive. She said she's gorgeous, which in women speak just means
I want to
say something nice. Okay. The other girl didn't want to hit the button. She saw the other girl reaching, and she also reached for it.
Mind you have to notice something, and I said that just right before we cut in, right? I said she's gonna say yes because it's a girl. She's gonna lie because it's a girl, right? Because with the guy, she was ready to be like, nah, you're not my type. No, you're not. I don't find.
Or she might say you're cute, which, depending on the context, can be a bad thing.
Yeah, exactly. All right, you're cute. I'm still ready to buzz. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, here we go. Let's hear the truth.
I feel like I would have more fun with you as a friend. Let's vibe.
Yeah, whatever. Let's see the ending. That's what I want to see.
I'm really glad.
That's fine.
Okay, Haley.
Yes.
You rejected men, women. I don't know that we have someone for you.
I find that controversial.
Let's see what she has to say. Oh, they ended it right there. Hold on. Oh my God. Where is that video at? Here it is.
Are there any type of philosophers that you would say you find yourself really a
Okay, hold on.
Kanye West really shook me, y'all.
Okay, Haley.
Yes.
You rejected men, women. I don't know that we have someone for you.
I find that controversial. How do you know?
What?
Because I've already gone through that.
Right, and she done went through all of them. Tall, dark skin, tall, white man. Woman, do you like trans? Them things?
Well, thank you for a lovely time. I had so much fun.
Aww, I had a lovely time with you. Thank you very much.
Anytime.
I'm Polly, Haley. I'm Polly.
Are there any-
So that was the end of it. I'm going to give my opinion on this and y'all ain't going to like it. To be completely honest, I hope this bitch never finds anybody. Because like I said, it's going to take girls like her to die off for people to get it. And I mean, for some reason, there aren't harsh enough consequences in this country for people to understand, like, oh, damn, I better not do this, or I better lower my standards. You know, it's kind of like that Ebony woman. What's her name? Ebony, that said she would date the guy that owns the buses, because she was talking about black ownership. I agree with that. But the question is, can you get somebody like that? The woman was 40. She hasn't gotten anybody yet. So therefore, you haven't gotten anybody like that. You need to lower your standards. In her case, bitch, you're ugly. You don't look good. Look, I want to look at her face. On a scale of 1 to 10, what would y'all rate this girl? She ain't no 7. She damn sure ain't no 6. She's 30. The only thing she got going for is she got big titties, as Abba would say. And her teeth is crazy. Oh my God. And look at her hairstyle. You came here with your hair frizzy like that. Oh, okay. Just toss on a chain and some earrings and you thought you looked good. With that green. Don't even go right. It's gonna take them to die off for y'all to get it.